Chris Menard here. We're going to take a look at advanced data validation right now. So in this current worksheet, I already have a list of departments. What we're going to do is we're going to find the unique values out of them. We're going to limit it to those values using a table on another worksheet, and our data validation will end up being based on that table. So if the table expands, the data validation list expands. Step one, let's go ahead and highlight column D. I'm going to pick on department and copy it. I'm going to add a new worksheet at the bottom and paste. Not required, but I'm going to just tweak the zoom, just increase it just so you can see this. I want to remove the duplicate values so everything's still selected. Data tab, remove duplicates in the data tools group. Click OK, click OK. So now we've got just unique values. It is a range, let's make it a table. Control and the letter T. Click OK, feel free to change the table style. This is just slightly easier to see, that is all. You don't need to do that. I do like to rename my tables. Table one means nothing to me. I'm gonna do TBLDPT for department. Press enter, so now my table is called TBLDPT. I can work right here. Let me show you the one issue with doing it this way, and it's just a minor issue. We're gonna go back to the Data Validation 2 worksheet. I'm gonna highlight D2, let's just go down to D30 to keep this easy. Data tab, data validation, make it a list, click in the source box. I can grab the mouse, click over on sheet one, and I'm just gonna select A2 to A7 and click OK. This is a pretty cool one. So now just to test it, I'm over in cell D22 and there sure enough are all my departments. What I like about this method, if I come back to sheet one and I'm just gonna do a sort A to Z, back to data validation two, hit the drop down and they did pick up. If I go back to sheet one, if I add training department and it just happens to be in the correct order still, it put it in cell A8. The issue is if I come back over here and click, it is not picking up training. Go back to sheet one, delete training. If I was to have put training and then pull the table back up if you need to, if I was to have inserted a row and put training in there, it would have got it and then I could sort again. But the trick is if you want to keep it automatically picking up and if case people want to type at the bottom, here's where we're going to get real advanced. Let's highlight D2 to D30 again, and I'm going to clear the data validation. Data validation, clear all. Change it to list. We created a table, and in that table, there's a field called department. You can use the INDIRECT function to reference that, and if you add to the bottom of the table, it'll pick up. So here is your function. Equal INDIRECT, open parent. What is it you want to reference? I did do open double quotes. I want to reference my table TBLDPT. That was the name of my table. Open bracket, because now I'm referencing the table, but what field in the table? That field is called department. Close the bracket, that is the name of the field. Close your quotes, and then a close parent. Now when I hit OK, I go to cell D22 just to look. Perfect. Back to sheet one. Put training back in here. That would be great. Training is back in here. The table expanded at the bottom, and over here is the training department right there. I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. This video is part of my Excel training course that is available online. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.